I returned home from the Boryeong festival to find my things outside. The clothes I had on were clean, with just a few splashes of mud. That is to say, I only watched the others have fun. My small pink suitcase and my patched backpack were set outside the door. I own more than those things, but at that time, I felt relieved, the less the better. My stepmother won. It was just my luck. It was raining that night. The downpour, though a mild drizzle, soaked my shirt and trousers as I dragged my luggage down the street. My teeth clattered from the cold and my eyes watered uncontrollably, blurring my line of sight. I didn't dare stop until I was at the Gwangjang Market. A safe distance from my former home. A safe distance from the only place I have ever called home. Namdaemun Market would have been a better option, but I could not walk there. For the first time that night, I exhaled and breathed in the smell of the various street foods already on display. Broth, please. The woman had makeup on that reminded me of clowns at the Lotte World amusement park where I once worked as security. She scooped the broth into two cups and pushed them to me. I drained them down quickly as she set fish buns before me, knowing what I usually bought. Hurriedly, I stuffed the snacks into my mouth, gulping a third cup of broth along with it. I wasn't hungry till her broth hit my tongue. I point, asking for more fish buns with my mouth full. "This one is on the house," she said, handing me another wrap. "Thank you." As I began to move again, I became more aware of others in raincoats, sheltering them from the rain pelting down on the earth. And I realized how drenched I appeared. My clothes were clinging to my skin and my hair. I must have looked like a soggy Subworld sandwich. Immediately, those thoughts crossed my mind. A feeling of uneasiness settled in the pit of my belly. I felt the hairs at the back of my neck stand as goosebumps sprouted out of my skin. The feeling was familiar. The fear I felt was almost palpable. It felt like in that sea of swarming people, someone was watching me or following me. My heart beat wildly as I forced my legs to move faster. I did not know where I was going, but I knew I had to keep going further. A sudden explosive sound tore through the air, sending a repetitive echo through my ears. Without a single thought, I fell to the ground and covered my head as my heart pounded wildly. Slowly, I raised my head to look around, but people were moving like nothing happened. An old man at the side stared at me in disbelief or amusement. I lifted myself from the puddle I was lying in, still looking around. On my right side, I spotted a man making rice puffs, hence the bang. I should have been relieved, but instead, my anxiety doubled. I felt whoever was following me was closer because of the time I spent on the ground. The market was not the safest of places. Finally, I decided to rest, because my feet were sore from walking without stopping all night. I moved to a table outside of a closed coffee and bakery shop and set my things down. I hugged myself as tears filled my eyes. I did not feel brave enough to spend the night in the market, yet I did not know what else to do. So I chose to keep walking. I walked until I was out of the Gwangjang Market, and then I took a route which could lead to the bus stop. I thought I could take a bus to Gyeongbokgung Palace. Or Gensol Tower. I knew admission was closed for the day, but with my skills, I could sneak inside and spend the night there. It was a night to consider every thought that came to my head. In frustration, I groaned and stomped the ground. I did not think my day would end like this. I could not help but wonder if my dad was worried about where I would spend the night. Was he lying awake thinking about me? A hand touched my arm from behind, and reflexively, I pushed back my elbow as I flew forward, using my leg to also hit my opponent attacker. But as soon as I turned around, I saw a handsome man clad in a black suit sprawled on the ground, clutching his stomach. My hand flew to my mouth once I realized who it was. I had hit the chairman's son. The chairman was head of one of the biggest fashion hotel construction conglomerates in the Myeongdong shopping district. Mr. Jong? He groaned without looking at me and rose to his feet. I am so sorry, sir. I did not intend to hit you. But when you surprisingly attacked me, I had to defend myself.
You attacked me. I did not attack you.
Yes, sir. I am so sorry, sir. His gaze softened as he looked at me and he stepped forward.
Are you okay? I saw you as I was driving home. You were walking in the rain, so I was trying to meet up with you to give you my umbrella.
You don't have an umbrella.
Yes, I forgot it in the car. I was already walking towards you when I remembered. All I knew was that you were walking alone at night. And I wanted to help you.
Those butterflies that were always awake when Minho Jung was in sight began to flutter endlessly. I did not understand why he was there or what his words implied, and I did not want to hope. We were from two different social classes. You have been following me?
Yes, until I could not find you anymore. I'm here to protect you.
Why? Why are you helping me? So it was him and not a thief. The rain had ceased, but the weather was very chilly. My first few days at the restaurant, he was mean to me. But after a few weeks, I noticed he was just everywhere I was, showing up unexpectedly. He was always friendly and kind to me. Also, he treated me differently from the other workers.
We will walk a little to reach where my car is parked.
I hesitated in following him after he began to move, because even if I got into his car, I did not have anywhere to go, and I did not want him to know that I would be sleeping at the restaurant. He paused and stared at me.
Do your legs hurt?
No. I don't have a place to sleep tonight, I blurted out finally.